The first hints that we were going to be affected by COVID-19 came in late January when Monash Health admitted Victoria's first COVID-19 patient. And at that time, we started to plan for a pandemic.
Before I even stepped foot in my placement, I knew it was going to be different to all other placements that I've had before.
It was a little bit daunting going into the general pod where the COVID positive and suspected patients were. But being part of the healthcare team as students and seeing our profession, you know, as we see our role models in pharmacists, it's exciting and it is reassuring for us as well.
Now we have people at all of our doorways, and so they make sure that only hospital staff come into the hospital, just because we have quite strict restrictions around visitors. There's lots of little social distancing things that you don't think about. So we have restrictions on how many people are out on the lifts at the same time. So there's a lot of stuff that has changed. And I think it will continue to stay this way in the future because we're now so much more aware of infection control than we were previously.
Around the middle to the end of March, where we started to see breakdown in the supply chain for medicines, you know, the so-called toilet paper effect, as the community pharmacies were experiencing a large demand on medicines as people started to think that they might be locked down for a prolonged period of time and they may not be able to get their regular medicines. That affected our hospital supply chain, and we had to start thinking about how we would maintain the supply chain of medicines.
Monitoring all of our medications, making sure that our critical medications are drugs that we can obtain, and having backup plans for when we can't obtain medications we would normally use as first line treatment for conditions. What is our second line treatment and can we access those drugs?
Having done our first placement there at the beginning of the year, we had become familiar with how they ran things back then, and then just within a matter of a few months, things escalated quite dramatically and they had to adapt a whole range of new protocols and new procedures.
All the pharmacists and all the health professionals obviously are just super busy trying to clear beds and prepare the hospital in case there's another surge of patients coming in.
For the pharmacy, an increased number of intensive care beds means an increased volume of critical care medicines that need to be in place.
So a particular area that pharmacists have really been involved in, especially during this pandemic, is drug shortages, coming up with plans and contingency plans and discussing with all relevant units and all relevant teams what we would do in a situation that we do lose quite a critical medication and what we do in that situation.
We're really keen to ensure that we take great advantage of the momentum that is built up in this emergency situation. You know, decision making was really fast during this time, and the willingness of teams to work together to ensure that patients were getting great care, we need to harness that energy, maintain it somehow, which is going to be tough in the absence of a tsunami of patients coming upon us. But that's the sort of work that we're doing right now.
To be able to help out in that situation, you know, feel like you're making a difference to people's lives. And then also for myself to be learning life skills at the same time, you know, it's a win-win situation for me and just a rewarding experience that I won't forget.
So we have seen that other hospitals around Australia are now starting to implement 24-hour pharmacy services as a response to the pandemic. And that's a huge step forward for pharmacists because it really does reinforce the fact that pharmacists are such a vital member of the healthcare team. We are there to help patients. We do a lot of medication counselling. We do a lot of medication reconciliation. So our role is really all about medication safety. And I think coronavirus has brought out what a key role pharmacists can play as part of the healthcare team.